Now I would like to give you some tips for writing the first draft. The first tip I have is to organize your results and your ideas by making an outline. So you can do this using the Reader Writer template that I have provided to you in this course. You could do something like draw storyboards on a whiteboard. You could draw on paper. You could make a traditional outline like you see on the bottom left part of the screen that we talked about earlier. Or you could write your key points on post-it notes and move those around on a wall or on a table. Or you can use index cards. You know, whatever works for you to think through how you're going to organize your paper. But it's going to help you tremendously to have a writing plan at this point and have an outline to get started. Now, you may adjust your outline later as we get into each of the specific sections, and that's okay, but at least have something to get started with. Some additional tips for writing the first draft. A good place to start is with the research question, and then work backwards from the research question to determine exactly which background information you need to provide in the introduction to funnel down to those knowledge gaps that will reveal your research question. From the research question, you will also work forward to the results and forward to the discussion section. Now, I have some additional tips for writing the first draft. These are tips about writing process and writing productivity. So when you're writing the first draft, the main thing is to get the words down. So don't worry about the length. It might be too long on the first draft or it might be too short on the first draft. Either one is okay. The second tip is don't edit as you write. This is going to slow you down tremendously, and it might be a total waste of time because if you spend 10 or 15 minutes getting a sentence perfect, and then in revisions you delete that sentence entirely, well, you can see that you wasted all that time editing. Even if you know that the sentence is not very good, or you feel like the sentence is not very good, keep moving. Just get the words down. I also recommend that you plug in the references as you go. That's going to make it a lot easier later, but if you find that plugging in the references as you go is slowing you down too much, you can leave a placeholder there to come back and put in the reference later. Now, one important thing is if you get stuck, like if you're starting to write and you just can't think of the next thing to put down, don't stay stuck and keep working on that same spot. What you should do is just write yourself a placeholder note saying, come back to this point and fill in this concept, and then keep going. You just want to get the words down on paper. Remember, you can't edit an empty page. Some more productivity tips for you on writing the first draft. Make sure that you write when you have a few spare minutes. So if you have 10 minutes between classes, if you have 10 minutes or 15 minutes between meetings, you can get a lot of work done in that small amount of time. All you have to do is sit down and start writing. Don't wait until you have the 3 or 4 hour block of time, because that's not going to happen very often. So it's really important that you be able to start writing on command. And you need to write even when the conditions are not ideal. Also, you need to be able to write consistently. I suggest every day and writing for 30 minutes every day. Now, whether every day for you includes the weekends or not, that's your choice. But at least during the week, write for 30 minutes every day. Make that a key priority. My point about writing every day is really about consistency. It's much better to be consistently writing every day than to be writing one day a week for a huge amount of time. So make sure you write even when you don't feel like it. As scientists, we are also writers because our work is not done until it's written and published. And so we have to be able to work on command. Writing is part of our job. It's not something to do when we feel like it or when we're inspired to write. We need to write when we need to write, no matter what's going on, even if you lost your lucky pencil. You are a writer, and what do writers do? They write. Now, I'd like to show you a couple of quotes. Harlan Ellison says that people on the outside think there's something magical about writing, that you go up in the attic at midnight and cast the bones and come down in the morning with the story. But it isn't like that. You sit in the back of the typewriter and you work, and that's all there is to it. I don't think any of us are going to be using typewriters, but you sit in front of your laptop or your desktop and you work, and that's all there is to it. Here's another quote from Ann Tyler. If I waited till I felt like writing, I'd never write at all. I know what she means, but I'll tell you, as someone who's been a full-time writer, when you get into the habit of consistently sitting down and writing, it becomes easier. Do you have writer's block? Can you have writer's block as a scientific writer? Well, I believe you can't. Scientific writers don't get writer's block because we're not creating stories out of the thin air. You know, we're not writing novels. We're not rewriting fiction and creative stories. We are documenting and we are explaining and we are interpreting. We're not afflicted with this thing called writer's block. If you're having trouble getting started with your writing, that's not writer's block. That is procrastination. I really think this quote from Steve Martin is funny. Writer's block is a fancy term made up by whiners so they can have an excuse to drink alcohol. So even if you don't drink alcohol, that's a funny quote. All right, we are to our action list for the week. First, I want you to call a meeting with all of your co-authors and determine who is going to be an author on your paper and determine the order that the authors will appear on the author list. This is the only thing on your action list that I recognize you might not be able to finish before you move on to the next lesson. But get it started at this point. Secondly, decide on a target journal and get those instructions to authors and start reading them and familiarizing yourself with the format that journal wants you to submit your paper. The third and fourth items here we didn't talk about during this lesson, but I want you to go ahead and get started on analyzing your data and sketching out your figures and tables. So even if you don't have all of the final data yet, if you're still collecting some data and analyzing it, you still know roughly what your figures and tables are going to look like, or at least what results they will contain. You may not know how those results are going to turn out yet, but you know what's going to be in those figures and tables. So sketch those out and then put all this together and start forming an outline for your paper using the reader-writer form that I have provided you, or some other method that we talked about. As we wrap up, I would just like to reiterate the learning outcomes for this lesson. Explain the submission and review process. Identify a target journal. Determine who should and should not be authors. And plan your first draft and outline your article. Again, please don't move on to the next lesson until you have achieved all of these learning outcomes. Go ahead and get to work, and happy writing.